Oh yeah. Look at the Duramax. It looks good. It looks good.
You could be winning this truck too. I think there's like 9 or 8 days left, something like that. Something small. There ain't many days left, but you could be taking this truck home.
That little STMS light right there freaking drives me crazy, but it's because the tire sensors were in the old tires that I took off this thing, and I never took them out of the tires to put back on for my new set. Therefore, it's just the light's just on until you can somehow deactivate it or something. I don't know. But anyways, guys, what is up? Hopefully you guys are doing absolutely fantastic. We're down to the wire, just over a week. I think there's about maybe 9 days left by the time you see this video, until the Duramax giveaway is over. The giveaway for this truck right here, lots of changes still coming. Tonight we're actually going over to Devin's shop to work on the first gen some more. Hopefully we can get some stuff moving along on that truck and get that thing rolling. And he's been a really good help with that kind of stuff. So appreciate it, Devin, when you see this. But guys, if you are wanting to enter to win this Duramax, keep in mind, this doesn't necessarily have to be the truck that you win. Yes, it's gonna be a Duramax that you take home, but you can sell the truck, pocket some cash, pay off some bills, buy a different truck, whatever you wanna do. But we are giving away this truck to one of you guys who enter the giveaway. Every $15 you spend on team-lnp.myshopify.com is another entry to win this truck. We're gonna get up to Devin's here and get some work done on the first gen. It's gonna be a good day. So we're back here with Devin, and one of his buddies are here. So he's been toying around with the first gen, and let him know what you did here to get it pieced together.
I went through everything. Hold on, Will. I went through everything on this to make sure we wouldn't have no leaks and all that. I took out the AC compressor just so I can get more clearance and I can tighten up stuff a little better. Like the returns for the oil off the turbos. I did all of those. I redid them and repiped them. Made sure all the oil lines were still good. And then made sure they were getting oil, first of all. We definitely need oil. And then other than that, no, she's good. So the way they had this, they wanted it to come up and all this for the charge pipe, but it wouldn't work because this turbo system doesn't go to this truck, so we make it. So
yeah, this is an HX35 remanufactured, and these run H1Cs on them, so it's not really a factory setup. Okay. Not to mention the kit itself isn't even for first gen, it's for a second gen truck. So the hood's different, the spacing between the turbo and where it would hit the hood and all that stuff is different. So he kind of had to piece it together to make it work.
Yeah, we did it and everything. I re-put the charge pipe down here. I cut it up and re-welded it and all that, and just got to get a new boot for here. Then I'm going to make the intake and all that come up through here and all that, so it comes and sits up in here. So it'll look a lot better than what it was.
for sure.
But no, I first started up and I was excited, dude. I was so pumped. I was like ready to just keep working on it all night. She's like, you can finish it this weekend. I'm like, okay, babe. Happy
when
wife,
you called
happy
me.
Life.
Yeah, when you called me and said it was running, I'm like, I want to freaking come here this thing before
dude.
I leave.
Oh, dude, it's awesome. I just can't wait. You want to start it?
Yeah,
let's start it. Start her up. Hell yeah, I was so excited when that first crank over. I was like, hell yeah. But nope, we ain't got no leaks or anything. I was so excited. The only thing that was leaking was that training fluid.
Yeah, and as soon as you kick it on, it pumps them out of there, yeah.
Nope.
But that's why we bought all this stuff here.
Oh yeah.
To get it all pieced back together and put some fluids all through it. But
oh yeah, but nope. We'll just tinker around some more stuff. Gotta get a boot to go on, and then once that's on, then I can start cutting more 4-inch piping for the intake, and then we bam with that part. And this weekend I'm gonna pump out the rest of the stuff, head studs, injectors, valve springs, and then the rocker and all that. So be pumping.
Sweet, let's get it going.
I'm excited.
Actually draining the oil right now. We just got a new oil filter put on before we get everything else buttoned up.
We can date it so it knows what date we changed the oil.
Yeah, so we can... I don't know when it was changed last. That oil is
She's black.
It's freaking super dark.
It's like Shook Knight black.
Yeah, that's about as dark as that boot right there.
For real. We had to cut the boot, so it's pretty.
Oh yeah, so he's gonna tell you what we're doing, because this was, believe it or not, kind of a hard boot to find. Kind of a pain in the butt.
Yeah, it's weird. It's very weird. So we needed a straight boot, and the only thing we had was a whole bunch of hillbilly rigging. So we're gonna make, we can't find a boot. I gave him the measurements and he called everywhere, and we couldn't, they're like, oh, we can't find that boot.
Like,
so,
oh, we can only do that in a 45 or a 90. We can't do a straight, or we can't do that size. I'm like, oh my gosh.
That's no good.
But anyways, this one fits really snug on here, actually really tight. And so what he's actually gonna do is double it up. And does that go into this?
Yep, it goes into this one.
It'll go into this one.
And then we'll tighten.
Snugly. And snugly. So it's gonna go into this one real snug. And then it's gonna create, it's kind of just like an extra thick boot, essentially.
Yeah, it's not like we're gonna have any boost leaks, you know?
Yeah, no. And this is actually a really heavy duty clamp.
Yeah.
So we can turn that thing down plenty and won't have any issues.
Gluten tight. Gluten tight. So.
But while he's working on that, I've been draining this oil. That's way overdue. And then I changed up that filter, but other than that, we're still just moving along, just little by little.
We're gonna pump it out. We're just make stuff work right now until we get the right clamp.
Yeah.
But it'll be okay.
And remember, guys, and for all of you guys that are stopping in new, and some of you might be like, what the heck are you doing? I call this project Play Truck, which is kind of like anything that works goes. And it's not like we're gonna stress over all the small details. As long as everything's functional, it drives down the road, and it's not spraying fluids or freaking boost leaks, we're good to go on this truck.
Yeah, this is definitely, it's not gonna be hillbilly. This is the only thing that looks hillbilly, okay? Let's just be honest. Like everything else, it's gonna be good. Like from what it came from when you order the parts and everything. We're making this fit on a first gen.
And this with a 7.3 intercooler, a non-intercooled first gen. So this is supposed to have a thing that goes up over top connecting it to run hot air. The second gen kit. So, I mean, it's a lot of, just making.
It's cool. It's going to be cool.
It's going to be cool.
Like other people, they're like, oh, I'll buy a turbo. And, you know, they have the space where they can modify their own pipes and everything. I mean, yeah, I've modified that pipe and welded it. But, you know, I don't know. Like, people just get too far into it and they're like, let's hang a turbo here. Well, it's better to just make everything hidden and like keep it more compact so you could get, you know, maybe down the road a bigger turbo.
Yeah. Maybe we want to do a third turbo.
For real. You never know. I mean,
yeah, so it's going to work. It'll be cool. Trying to figure out, because he had some ideas for how to run the cold air intake piping, because the whole kit, of course, we had to kind of modify to make it work in the first place. And so he's like thinking about running it down under here because we have all this wasted space here in these trucks. And I'm like, well, let's just see if we can jam it down in there. And of course, nothing here is permanent yet. So we still got to move some lines and heat wrap some stuff. But I'm just going to see if that pipe fits down there. And that boot actually has an angle on it to where you can rotate it around to where it fits. And it fits right down through there. And it's not rubbing right here on the alternator, but it sits right in there. And you can see that it would close the hood just fine. Like, it would be fine. Now, the only thing that's gonna be a little bit of a pain, that downpipe.
Yeah, we're gonna have fun with that.
Yeah, that would be fun.
But
not be fun.
It'll be all right. Hey, that's what we're here for. We're here to make people say that something's not gonna fit, and we'll make it fit.
Yeah, we'll make it fit.
Exactly.
I was actually kind of shocked that this did fit, though.
For real.
I mean, it's close, but
I was about to start cutting stuff up and re-welding stuff to make it fit and do all kinds of crazy stuff, but he was like, hey!
See if it fits first. Yeah.
This is the only thing that is bugging us, is this the charge pipe from the second one up, back up to the main.
You know, the cold air side of that, because it rubs on this wastegate. But he's got an idea that if he heat wraps it, not necessarily for the heat purpose of it, but just to keep it to where it's layered up there good.
It shouldn't rub a hole in it.
Yeah, it shouldn't rub a hole in it. I mean, as long as you keep an eye on it too, just to make sure, but it should be fine.
We can always get a hard pipe, because a lot of guys, what is supposed to be here is a hard pipe, so we can always get a hard pipe to come up and around back to
that
it.
That is something that most kits have is not rubber.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be a pipe that goes in here, comes out, and one pipe, like almost like an S looking pipe. But.
Yeah.
Huh?
It's gotta be a little loud.
Oh yeah.
Nothing's in the way, is it?
I don't think so. I think you're good.
Something's leaking.
Oil? Something.
Yeah, I just start the thing, dude.
Watch your face. You ready?
Yeah. All right. It's an oil filter.
It is?
Yep.
That's why I watched it.
Oh, yeah, I can see it now.
More again!
Here, I'm wanting to blame Devin for something.
I know.
It's all right. Guys, I screwed up. There's freaking oil.
What happened?
Let me take a look here.
I wonder if the oil, see if the O-ring.
This exhaust.
Sorry about your Ford.
Oh, you're good, man. Your lens is covered in oil.
No, that's because when I was filming, I was like right here, and then it started throwing the fan.
It's good. I was like, dude, I started this dang thing. How many times did we start this to make sure no leaks? Like 5 times.
Well, when I first got here, before we touched it, there was nothing.
Yeah, just to show you.
So what happened? Actually, you said it in the video. When I took the filter off, and I should have checked. Didn't take the O-ring. Didn't check to see if the O-ring was on the filter. So that's what happens.
Double O-ring. What up?
Yeah.
Get that fixed and then start her back up.
Yeah.
We're going for the attempt again. Yeah.
Shop here.
Yeah, you know, cleaning our oil mess, but it's okay. So we got the charge pipe on, the fittings for that, the boots, got the intercooler done, cleaned up stuff how we kind of want to keep it nice and clean, and we're just go for another day, get injectors done, head studs done, and then off to the sweet tranny shop, and then we'll be doing burnouts with her soon. So
yeah.
It's gonna send it.
We gotta get a rear locker in this too. I keep telling them I wanted to do a rear locker on the truck so it'll not do such one wheel peels everywhere, you know.
Oh yeah.
We're rolling again. Sorry, I had to clean the camera up.
Yeah.
What I was saying in terms of the turbo side, all he's really gotta do over here yet is somehow make a downpipe. And I know that the first gen downpipes from the factory are pretty much a 90. They come right off the turbo and they shoot straight down in between the bell housing where the turbo hangs, and then they go straight out the back. But obviously now that we have to have a 5-inch, that's a little bit different, but.
Yeah, we'll make it work. I mean, what was the stock, like a 3, maybe?
It was 3.5, I think.
Yeah, so, yeah. I mean, what's a little beaten and motivation we can't do with the firewall, I mean.
Well, I told you, you might be able to just, you can see where it's kind of like, there's like this thin square edge that comes straight. I might even be able to trim that back some.
Yeah, we should.
That's not that important.
That's kind of like least worries, but
yeah.
We got to get there.
We can buy some more of this heat wrap and all that.
Oh, yeah.
So explain what you did here too with that and why, because I'm sure they're going to ask.
Oh, with the
heat wrap.
Oh, yeah, so the heat shrink. We just got a zip tie right now because we kind of ran out of clamps. And we have this clamp right here that's supposed to go on it. So this whole pipe is running on the wastegate. So we didn't want it to rub through or any holes or anything. So we just put heat shrink around it the easiest way. So, I mean, it'll work for now. And if it ever puts a hole in it, we'll just have to make a hard pipe for it, like a lot of the other turbos that guys run. So other than that, should be pretty good. What do you think?
Looks pretty good. And I'm glad that this actually fit right through here. We already showed you guys this, but it actually fits right through there. And you can still get the oil filter off from underneath, believe it or not, on a first gen at least, because it's everything's so open. But you're pretty good to go. All he's going to do is he's going to get to doing the injectors, valve springs, governor spring, head studs, rocker pedestals, and all that jazz. And then he'll be ready to
do burnouts.
Yeah. Yeah, just about. So. Anyways, man, thanks again for the help today.
Yeah, no problem, man. Thanks for coming and splurging with the oil.
Yeah, the oil filter. Apparently, there wasn't another O-ring on there. I thought I doubled them up. It just wasn't on tight enough, I'm guessing. It just wasn't twisted on there nice and snug and whatever.
We got it, though.
Cracked open and started spraying oil. But anyways, thanks again for the help today, and we will see you back here soon.
Go. Peace.